Hey everyone, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Fuel pressure is extremely important for your engine's fuel injection system. Too much fuel pressure or too little fuel pressure can cause issues with fuel delivery that ultimately can lead to issues starting your engine, it can lead to performance related issues, and it can even cause serious engine damage if your engine is running too lean or too rich. So in this video, we're going to talk about fuel pressure regulators and how they work. We'll go ahead then and talk about signs and symptoms of a bad fuel pressure regulator, and then we'll go ahead and finish this video off with a diagnostic checklist that you can go ahead and follow step by step to diagnose and fix the issue that you're having. So let's go ahead and talk about fuel pressure regulators. Fuel pressure needs to be regulated so that the injectors deliver the appropriate amount of fuel that the engine needs. If your fuel pressure is too high, that can ultimately end up in you dumping too much fuel into the engine, which causes your engine to run rich, and that can ultimately lead to wasted fuel, and it can also cause damage to the engine's internals. On the other side of the spectrum, if your fuel pressure is too low, we can be sending too little fuel into the engine, which causes your engine to run lean, which can lead to misfires, performance-related issues, and internal overheating, which can cause serious internal engine damage. Ultimately, running rich or running lean is very bad, and to make sure that neither of those happen, we need to make sure we have the appropriate fuel pressure, and that's where the fuel pressure regulator comes into play. Now, there are two different styles of fuel pressure regulators. We've got the older, what's called a return style, and then the modern returnless style. So if you have a vehicle probably somewhere around early 2000s and older, you likely have a return style fuel pressure regulator. So what that is you have an actual regulator and fuel return lines that are mounted around the fuel rail. And so that regulator is what controls fuel pressure, and it takes any excess fuel and sends it back into the gas tank via these return lines. It is a bit more mechanical of a process in terms of fuel delivery relative to the more modern style, which kind of early 2000s and later you'll find on most vehicles. The returnless style actually has the fuel pressure regulator integrated directly into the fuel pump. This is important to understand what you have, because there of course are a number of different components at play here. With the modern returnless style, the most important thing is going to be the fuel pump, because that's what the regulator is actually integrated into. But with the return style, you're going to have actually a physical fuel pressure regulator that's mounted onto the fuel rail. You're going to have vacuum lines that control that regulator, and then you're also going to have fuel return lines to send excess gas back into the gas tank. But regardless of the type of fuel pressure regulator you have, the signs and symptoms are all going to be about the same. So let's go ahead and talk about that. Some things that you might experience are hard starting, rough idling or stalling at idle, loss of power or lack of acceleration, misfires or engine hesitation, black smoke coming out of the exhaust, and then six on our list is going to be smells of gasoline coming from your engine. Now, the causes of a bad fuel pressure regulator do differ depending on what style you have. On the older return styles, you can either have a bad fuel pressure regulator itself, or you can have a vacuum leak coming from the vacuum line that runs to the intake manifold. And then on the newer returnless styles, when the fuel pressure regulator goes bad, because it is integrated into the fuel pump, you usually have to replace the whole fuel pump assembly, and it does make it very difficult to tell whether it's the regulator or the actual pump itself that's bad. But ultimately, because they're integrated, the regulator going bad means the fuel pump itself has gone bad. That makes things a little bit simpler from a replacement standpoint for modern vehicles. Now, when it comes to diagnosing a bad fuel pressure regulator, things can get a little bit difficult, because having either too high or too low a fuel pressure can be caused by a number of things, such as a failing fuel pump, leaking or clogged injectors, a clogged fuel filter, a bad fuel pressure sensor, electrical issues with the pump, or leaking or clogged fuel lines. So let's go ahead and talk about our diagnostic checklist here to go ahead and help you narrow down what the potential cause might be. So the first thing you're going to want to do is check for any obvious leaks or smells coming from the engine. You're gonna wanna look around the fuel injectors, the fuel rail, and the fuel lines to make sure you don't see any leaks coming from those areas. Second, if you have a return style older system, go ahead and pull the vacuum line. If you have a bunch of fuel inside the vacuum line, then that means that the diaphragm in the fuel pressure regulator has failed, and that's causing fuel to leak into the vacuum lines. And so if that's the case, you need to go ahead and replace the fuel pressure regulator. From there, you're gonna wanna go ahead and go to step three, which is gonna be to turn your engine with the ignition on, but don't turn the engine on. Whenever you turn the ignition to on, you should hear a buzzing or a whirring sound, and that is the fuel pump priming. And so if you don't hear the fuel pump priming, that means that you potentially have an issue with the fuel pump itself, or with an electrical component that sends power to the fuel pump. If you don't seem to have an issue with the fuel pump priming, the fourth thing I would do on this list is go ahead and check the fuel filter. If your fuel filter gets clogged, that can severely reduce fuel flow and lead to low fuel pressure. The fifth thing here is gonna be to test the actual fuel pressure, which gets into a little bit more technical of a diagnostic process here. But there are ways to do it, either with a scan tool, if you have a returnless system, or if you have an older return style, you can actually hook something up to the fuel rail and test pressure at the fuel rail. And you'll want to go ahead and test both of them at idle and under load and compare them to what the OEM specs should be. So those are the general kind of diagnostic steps to go ahead and diagnose fuel pressure related issues. If you have low fuel pressure, you probably either have a bad fuel pump, a clogged filter, leaking injectors, or crimped fuel lines. If it's not one of those four things, then you've got a bad fuel pressure regulator. And in the case that you have high fuel pressure, that can be caused by a kinked line in your fuel return system for the return style. Or if you have a returnless style, you could have a bad electrical signal coming from the ECM or a bad fuel pressure sensor. If it's not the fuel pressure sensor or an electrical issue with the fuel pump, then it's gonna be the fuel pump or the regulator, and you're gonna need to go ahead and replace the whole unit. So ultimately, for modern setups, make sure it's not your fuel injectors, it's not your fuel filter, it's not the fuel pressure sensor. And if it isn't one of those, it's the fuel pump. And for the return style systems, if it isn't the fuel pump, the vacuum lines, or a clogged fuel filter, then it's gonna go ahead and be the fuel pressure regulator. Anyways, that covers it for our video on fuel pressure regulators. I hope this video was helpful. If you guys appreciate the content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all our future content.